gallery there in front of you with Brendan Vaughn. Y'all have also in your packet the two department heads that said yes, and so we'll be voting on that tomorrow. Also, I was going to get you to look at Jim Rittrogel's proposal again. We really do need to talk about that. I got in touch, tried to get in touch with Chris Pate today to see if, you know, he could help us out. If something didn't go that way, you know, we can maybe get him in to help us with the planning committee. I'm mostly concerned about that planning committee when we have that in the zoning board. So, just what do y'all think? What's your thoughts on it?
Jim agreed to do that, or?
Where did 98 come from, instead of the 65, like we?
That was Jim's proposal.
92.
Oh, yeah, 92, whatever it was.
92.
I asked him, would he do the 65, and he said no. That was pretty straightforward that he wanted that.
I know we reached out to Chris Pate.
I did today, and like I said, he didn't get back, he's not able to get back with me. Is that something that I can put?
I just think if Jim was doing it for 65, and he's going, I mean, we don't need to, you open a can of worms with the new guy. When he comes back and you say he's going to do 65 and do it for Jim for 92, then he's going to argue, why can't I get 92? Where does the 92, Jim needs to say, where does the 92 come for? We've always budgeted 6,500, and I'm fine with that.
Yeah, I agree with that. I think that the young man coming in, why is he going to make 65 and the other going to get 92? I understand the other got more training, but you know, is it incentive for him to get to that 92, or are we going to just stick with the 65? Like we was paying Jim. That's what I agree with.
Another thing I was going to ask, if it was okay that we would have Jim come in a couple of days a week to train. So, would that be okay with y'all? Okay.
Is it going to be free?
No, it's not going to be free. Nothing's free. You know that. And I'll send out an email in the morning to everybody on that. So, and if we can get him in Wednesday, maybe 2 days a week, and then we've got other building inspectors that's going to help the new building inspector, and then also Ricky, help me out, what's his last name, over at Bolivar, that always does the inspections for the electrical. No, it's not Whitaker. It is Watson or something like that, Ricky Watson over there. He would reach out and help a little bit, but that's still not going to be that hands-on training that we need, so we're going to need somebody to give us a little. So we'll work on that. So everything good on that, or any questions on that?
With Jim, I'm assuming that him coming back, if he comes back, he's going to be paid
contract
because
yes.
of TCRS,
mm-hmm.
so he can't be paid like his own. Anymore.
Right, due to his retirement?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's correct. Next thing, we'll have to vote tomorrow night to keep the speed bump or not keep the speed bump on Higginbottom, so we can lay this where you don't have to discuss it anymore. So is that being okay with y'all to put that on the agenda?
Yes. Ready to get it over with.
Okay. Next up is going to be Ray, and Ray's going to talk pretty fast.
Yes, Ray's going to
He's going to talk about
fast.
His bids for his
can't
building.
Move very fast, but I'm going to talk pretty fast. Okay. I've got two bids on the building, the new office building. One of them is from KNV, if you just want to pass those around. I'm sorry I don't have copies, but if you want copies, I'll bring them tomorrow night. KNV, which if you notice, and this is from Design Build. Now, Design Build is more...
Design Team.
Design Team is a lot more specific in what it is. If you take a quick look, I had to call KMV 4 or 5 different times just to get what we got, and what we got is not very specific. There's 8 or 9 windows in the whole building. They have 4. So it's just not, you know, not very detailed, not very good. I think I was more of a nuisance to them than I was, you know, looking to give them some work. Jim told me there was a, I have it in my phone, a name of a company that did some work for him. I called them up. They weren't insured or licensed, so we couldn't use them. I talked to the guy building down at the vape shop by Waterbury, by Walmart. That addition onto that building, they came, said they were going to come and take a look at it. I called them the next day, let them know that I was waiting for them, and they decided they didn't want to do it either. So I've got 2 bids. One of them is very specific. One of them is not so, and we're going to have to go back to get a better detailed bid on it. But you know, it's up to you. I'd like not to lose my new clerk, because she found the mouse this week, and it was like Tiny Tim tiptoeing through the tulips, and she just wasn't too excited about that, so she started talking about the new office afterwards. But it is a situation that needs to be done, and you know, I'm just bringing you the information, and I'd like to move forward with it.
Yeah, we'll still have to do a proper bid package.
Can you not do the site work with the equipment you have?
We certainly can. We can, and they know that. That's why they listed it 2 different ways. Or at least design team did. And we said we could do it. But if I take somebody off to do that, then I'm not doing something else. And for the price, I mean, it's entirely how you guys want to work it. You know, it's just up to you. We could certainly do the site work on it and have them, you know, tell them what we need to do, and we can certainly do that. Or we can just let them come in and do it all and get it done.
So we already requested bids, right? Didn't get any?
Yes, I requested.
Search these out.
Yes, I searched all of these.
Vote on these.
Yep. That's what I'm asking.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
We're going to put that on the agenda for tomorrow. Next up is going to be a second reading on the ordinance of rezoning the Knights property. We'll do that tomorrow. And then also, second reading on the codes that need to be adopted per state fire marshal. We'll have that. Do y'all have any questions on those two? Okay. And I do want to say thank you for the board retaining that engineer, Mr. Alton Heathcote, and his team. They came out. We went up and down Henco Drive for about 2.5 hours. That was great, educational, and I believe that's going to really help us. They are very good at knowing, you know, they know that the city needs to save money, and they know that this needs to be fixed, so they are very good at this. So I'm appreciative of that. So we'll get that report pretty soon. He did send another engineer down that was very knowledgeable. I was very impressed. I learned a whole lot. That was a half a day of running around with that guy, and he was very nice. I can't think what his name was, but he came up there to see Nick.
Andrew.
Well, yes, Andrew. That's correct. He seemed to me top notch, and he knew what he was talking about. So thank y'all for that. So hopefully we'll get that resolved, and I'll keep y'all in the know on that. Next up is Chief Holly. You have it right here. He wants to declare surplus on the 2014. Chevy Tahoe. Do y'all have any questions for him? We'll put that on the agenda. Yes?
Yes.
Okay. And also, I didn't have this one because I just received it from Ray, and I'll have it in your packets up there tomorrow night. But he's also declaring surplus on two vehicles, 2005 Chevy and another 2005 Chevy. Is that correct, Raymond?
Yes.
Okay. Y'all need to look at that? No.
It's all work trucks?
Yes, all work trucks, pushing 300,000 miles.
Not much left.
Not much left at all.
Also, I have got to put on there to vote the new planning committee members. As you know, I'm learning, so I didn't know about the committee of getting together to make where we would get the building inspector. So Jim brought this to my attention before he left, and so we need to approve these. That's on here: Sherry Kaiser, Brett Hill, and Homer Watson. Is that something okay with y'all? Have any questions with that? So that'll be on the agenda tomorrow. And I was just going to see if Alderman Austin wanted to say anything about the Patriot Park. If you wanted to talk about that.
Just waiting on the state to process the contract so we can start any work up there. They said they don't know when it'll be, but it's on somebody's desk waiting in
Today,
somewhere.
Okay. All right.
While I'm talking about it. Question, how's the grant going on the tennis courts?
It's turned in, and Melissa Davis is waiting, me and her is waiting on getting whatever the paperwork that would come right back so that I can send on to her. But the letter of intent has been done. Actually, we've done it twice. I've done it twice just to make sure that I've done it correctly. So, I had to do the letter of intent.
Okay.
So I've got the proof of that, and then after that, she will finish it up. When she gets everything come back, she'll start on the next level of it.
That wouldn't answer in my emails.
All right. Next time is we're going on to the town budget discussion, and I guess Miss Angie Deaton, you want to do anything on that, or do y'all have anything?
Well, I sent it on Friday, so that I was hoping everybody would be able to look at it, and I'm open to
any kind
discussion.
I had a few things I hadn't sent in yet. Is that going to be a problem with us?
No,
sending it?
That's fine. This
because,
right here is
yes.
100% right. Draft.
Good, because I hadn't had time to sit down, and I've got a few questions, and I'll send it out. I was just making sure that that was still okay.
Yeah, this is wide open.
Did y'all have any questions?
Pertaining to that.
Pertaining to the budget, anything in there? No?
Given raises, where we're going to come up with the...
This budget right here has 2% flat rate. That's all it's on it. So whatever you...
Get competitive, 2% is not going to make it. So except to get competitive, so Raymond can hire, so anybody else can hire.
I did 2%. Yeah. Any other discussion, you know, can come up with whatever y'all want me to plug in, I can plug in.
Well, we want it more, but plugging it in, it ain't got it. We can't do it. You see it.
I'm saying that the revenue is right there.
There's only a couple of those that we can change.
Yeah. You do whatever you want to do. I'll just plug the numbers.
You have any insight on what you want to say?
I do have a few things. But I'll email all that to you. I'm not sure exactly. I've been running my numbers, but I've also been putting out some other flyers, so I've not been able to put everything together yet. So I was hoping I had it ready. I apologize for that. I just hadn't had time yet.
Yeah, speaking of
that, we need to go ahead and get that second meeting scheduled.
Second meeting.
For the budget in June.
Yes, I've put that on here right here, so we can go ahead and do that special call meeting.
Yeah, I had something also. We speaking of the budget, since everybody's losing everybody, how's that going to affect everybody?
I'm sorry. What do you mean?
I mean, people leaving, quitting, because they can't.
Well, that's why I was bringing up.
Right, right.
I know.
Yeah.
The pay.
Yeah.
Pay's going to have to go and keep anybody.
Yeah. I know. Kim, how are you?
Well, we interviewed. I tried to hire two. I was able to hire one. I a young man I brought in. I said, first step is, you know, drug screen. And then he came back the next day and says, I'm not interested. Went down to the third person. I did a background Google search on him, and that's as far as I got with him. And so I hired one person out of two. So I'm just going to wait and see. Somebody's coming in later this week I'm going to talk to. And what's hurting all of us is, I don't know if y'all know, the Highway Patrol, I think, got a 30% raise. Yeah. Heard a rumor that one of mine has applied. I think the sheriff's got five that's applied. Yeah. There's no way we can match what they're paying. I know that. But that's the way it is.
So how many you shot now?
One.
One. How about you, cop?
Well, right now I'm okay, but I've got two of the part-timers. One's went to Olive Branch, the other one's went to Oxford. Memphis fixed to give 15% pay raise. I've got one that's going back to school right now. She may go to the hospitals of phlebotomists. Money's it. Mm-hmm. Collierville and Germantown, they're raising their taxes. They've got to get their pay up, so everybody around us is raising taxes to get the pay up to match.
Yeah, what about you, Raina?
I'm short one out on workman's comp. So we're struggling and swapping guys around to cover that, but everybody's got a question because they watched the last meeting online and, you know, heard no raises at all. And, so everybody's a little bit nervous. And even today, you know, a couple of people asked me, you know, did you hear anything about raises or what's going to happen? And I said, you know, I have no idea yet, so.
I think we need to come up with something
for
the company.
We're going to have to come up with something. I understand my nephew, a state trooper, he just got a 35% raise. He was happy to get it. And he said, how y'all going to make it?
35
a lot. Yeah,
it's a lot.
Yeah, he said, how y'all going to make it in the small Selma for just giving a little bit? And my cousin's a policeman in Henderson. He said, when they top out, they $25 an hour. Mm-hmm. Once they get certified.
What day in June do y'all have on your calendar?
First meeting will be the 13th, so it needs to be something in that last week.
27, 28, 29.
Okay.
Can
we do it
the 29th?
That
I'm good
with
that.
Sounds good to me.
You know,
at what time?
What time do you be here, John? 5:30.
And
that won't take 2 minutes.
Well, I ain't fancy with all them phones. Just tell me when it is.
Miss Jill Holland will speak at the board. She just wants to introduce herself from Southwest in Jackson. She used to be the mayor of McKenzie, but she's doing planning, all different things for Southwest in Jackson. She just wanted to come meet y'all and just to, you know, tell you a little bit about herself, so what she does. So she'll just be on the agenda to talk for just a few seconds. Anything else?
I'd like a clarification from Kim on what happened Friday night and Saturday night.
I'm not sure about the Friday, what you're talking about Friday.
Friday night at the community center.
I'm not sure that I can answer that.
Okay.
Quentin was there, and
that's fine.
They didn't call me. I heard they had a fight. All I can tell you, but I don't know what happened.
They did. I thought we met. Didn't we say when we have anything at the Civic Center that we would have police?
I was there.
Y'all was there.
Quentin was there.
Oh, so they had a fight.
But whatever it wasn't bad enough for him to call me. I just heard they had a fight.
What happened Saturday night?
Talking about Saturday?
Saturday.
Mm-hmm. All right. At the
wrestling match. Or whatever you want to call it.
I haven't heard nothing happen to that.
At the wrestling match?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay.
I don't know what you're talking about.
There were some things going on that wasn't appropriate. appropriate around ladies and gentlemen.
No, I don't wish to talk about it at the wrestling.
At the wrestling match. It was wrestling outside and inside.
I don't wish to talk about it at the wrestling match. We had plenty going on Saturday, but.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you did. Yeah, you did. Inside and outside.
I don't know nothing about the wrestling match.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure I was clear. I heard some things about it, and I said, I don't know. I wouldn't know.
No, I don't know it.
Yeah. Fair enough. Neither one of us know then.
Yeah, I don't know.
I thought
you were talking about stabbing at the gas station.
I know about that, too. I almost was there for it. Yeah. I seen it, but I stopped.
And also, I put in here, just to read about Arts and McNary, the mural that's going up over beside Miss Peggy Griffin's store. I don't know if we told them we didn't. I didn't know if we had anything to give them in the budget. So they requested some money. Said they it's going to be $22,000 plus. So I just put it in there so y'all can look and see if you had anything you wanted to give to that. I told them I didn't know, so I will give that to the alderman to look at. So.
They want 22 there?
Oh, no, no, they don't want 22. Well, they probably do want 22,000. But they want, you know, something. If you could give something, they just want you to look at it and see. Anything else?
Did we put the movie project on the agenda?
I did not. I did not. You can, if you need to talk, you can. Do you want to?
I did send everybody an email, but it is an opportunity to bring residents into the community if we pull this off. I'm working with Bob Schott and Bo Stinson. He played Walking Tall the last two movies in the television series. And when he was here in June, last June, he was here, he's a screenplay writer now, but he's been in the last three Quentin Tarantino movies, so he's pretty active. The guy's 82, but he's been in over 100 movies. But when he was here in June, he was just signing photographs, you know, from his 40 years ago when he was in the Walking Tall movies. And he just kind of saw, I guess you would say, our plight. He saw a lot of families come through. He was showing around the community, and he thought, you know, he talked to Larry Smith, and Ron Dant started the conversation, who I guess we need to say a prayer for him because he just had a heart attack. But Ron Dant started a conversation with Bo because Bo said, you know, it's very unfortunate that McNary County didn't benefit from the Walking Tall movies at all. And so he said, you know, and Bo said maybe we could do something about that. So he started talking to Ron Dant, and he's talked to Paige Wally and many people at the governor's office and at the state level. And there's really not a lot of money to put in initially, but they will follow up with the producer and give them, Tennessee's increase their tax incentives to 40%. 40% for production, for talent, and if they hire a Tennessean, they get an extra 10%. So, I mean, they're trying to compete with Georgia and Louisiana. And so Bo said, I would like to write a screenplay, and it's called He Returns, and it's likely based on the life of Buford Custer. Because he couldn't get the rights. He tried to get the rights to Buford Custer's name, but it was Bing Crosby Productions produced the original movies, and they sold the rights to, like, Village Roadhouse Productions or something a few years ago. So Bo said, you know, he ended up talking to me at some point, and I think through Steve Sweat, I'm not even sure. But anyway, he called and said, you know the local people, can you help me pitch it? And so I partnered with, you know, him and his team and just started talking to people about it. And Adamsville, of course, is very interested. David Lechner and the Adamsville board, of course, they have a vested interest with the museum. Then I've talked to Jessica at length about it. And, of course, we have the jail is pretty much in the same exact condition it was when Buford was sheriff. And we preserved that very well. And so Bo said, I can't use the Pusser name, but I can come back. And he would like to incorporate rockabilly, bluegrass. He knew Elvis. He's old enough to run around with Elvis. And he said, I would like to pitch a movie that this person, you can assume he is Buford, comes back and he's doing good. You know, he's working with the police. He said, I could have a job at Dollar General, whatever works. He said, I want it to be relevant to today. But I would like for Tennessee to benefit. So long story short, we were just having difficulty raising momentum, and Bob Schutt has, you know, offered to, he's going to host a meeting here Friday with me, and Ron was going to be there, he was going to be there on Zoom, but obviously we know he won't be there now. Paige Wally will be there, Joe Barker, Southwest Development. Because when I talked to Bob, he said, Janet, one thing we've learned in Savannah is that we're probably not going to benefit from any manufacturer from Blue Apple Ford. We're too far away. We don't really have the right space. And he said, McNary County doesn't have the right space. He said, but if we're smart, we could work together and maybe pitch this movie project and also pitch a rural tourism project as well. Have both Hardin and McNary counties work together in tandem on, you know, each county has to raise $109,000 collectively for the movie project. It is an investment. You will get it back 1.5 times your money back. So if you invested, say, $40,000 or $50,000, and I know it sounds like a lot of money, but I think in your budget, if it's paid up front and then you get it back, and then we get over 200 good-paying jobs with this production, it will pay off dividends. And so what Bo is asking, and he would be available for questions tomorrow night if you guys had any, I could get him on the phone. He is wanting to, for us collectively, to pay for the screenplay, which is $208,000, and that's apparently a requirement through the Writers Guild of America that he's part of, the union. And then there'll be a few extra dollars, probably $2,000 for his travel out here to meet with us, kind of see, you know, meet with police officers, get to know the people in the town, maybe have a night with Bo, and he wants to just go around and kind of see what's relevant here in McNary and Hardin County. And so, and Hardin County wants to come up, or has pledged to come up with the additional $109,000. So Friday's meeting, we're hoping just to have a meeting of the minds and talk about what McNary County can come up with between the county, the cities, et cetera. So obviously, say it'd be $35,000 to $40,000 if we did the three major cities, or two major cities in the county. Guys wanted to help with that. I don't know how much they have in their budget. They're small, but they want to contribute something. So we're just trying to say, can we kill two birds in one stone? Can we, you know, get this movie project, which is guaranteed to bring literally millions of dollars in the community? Can we partner with Hardin County on a tourism project to bring people here to see our murals, rockabilly, cereal burgers, etc.? But like what Bo said, he's Swedish, and he says, what you guys don't understand is that Europeans love a little piece of Americana, and they will pay big dollars to come and visit you and kind of just see what you're all about. Now, of course, we need to prepare for that, get museums ready, get the jail ready. And he said he would even help pay for some, like, voiceovers and things. Like, he said it would be really ideal if, like, we picked up someone in a period car, in a patrol period car, and at, you know, the airport at Nashville or Memphis, gave them that they would pick the crime of their choice. Someone would shackle them, put them in the car, bring them here, and, you know, they would spend the night in jail and say maybe they wanted to get out the next morning, maybe they wanted to spend another night in jail. And he said you could even let them out and let them go to a church of their choice, have a nice Sunday dinner, and take them back to the airport. He said, I know that sounds corny to you. He said, but people would pay major big dollars for that. And so, you know, he thinks, and Bob said, you know, with the riverboat tours they have now, they were stopping in Savannah 4 times a year. And he said they calculated that they were making $21,000 a day every time they stopped in Savannah just for a few hours. And so now they're coming April, May, and June, and they're saying one day out of the weekend, you know, 4 times a month or 5, depending on the weeks of the month. So he said, we're making an extra $300,000 just on this little riverboat tour. And he said, and sometimes they dock on Sunday. And he said, there's not a lot open on Sunday. I'm not sure what they do, but they're spending money. So he said, if I've learned anything, is to value tourism. Now, you probably all know that Savannah's building a $25 million marina to the right of the bridge. They have $12 million that they've saved for that project, and I guess they'll bond out the rest. But Wayne Gerald's owned all that land, and he has graciously sold it to the city of Savannah. And the only thing that's holding them up is the 6 acres that TVA owns, and they're hanging on to it tooth and nail, but I think they'll work through that. But, Bob said, we could, all of the influx of people that are coming into Blue Oval Ford, we could surely attract them to the river, you know, to McNary County. You know, we could really work to have events and, you know, token stores that are selling all kinds of chops, keys, and souvenirs to attract people to our communities. Because like him, he feels like we probably depend on tourism a lot. We don't realize how much it brings into the county, but it brings a lot. So I've got examples. If you didn't get your email, I've got examples of the contract. So if you gave $40,000, the day the production started, you would get 1.5 times your money back. So what happens is the screenplay's paid for and written. Beau comes to visit us, he finishes all of his work, and then he shops it to Comcast or Netflix or whatever. Now, he hopes the movie would be a pilot that would turn into a TV series, and that would be longer-term jobs. But just to give you an example, Edge in Memphis, the Economic Development Growth Engine, reported that Memphis shot the last, I think it was a portion of season 3, wasn't it, of season 9? I mean, Young Rock. I didn't know the Rock started in Memphis wrestling. I didn't know that history. But they made, Memphis alleged that they made $37 million off of that one partial production. Dwayne Johnson got approved for seasons 4, 5, and 6, and he agreed to come back to Memphis. Memphis is anticipating $74 million just for that one TV production annually. And so the Shelby County Commission really believes in this so much, they put up $500,000 for an apprenticeship for both TV and movie producers, movie producers, because they want to start competing with Georgia and Louisiana for the millions and millions they're bringing in annually. But Memphis has moved up to the number 17 for movie makers list, where to live if you're a movie maker. Knoxville, for a small market, I had no idea, is number 6. It's in the top 10. And, you know, Bob feels like, and he's really, really into this, I think, but he feels like, why couldn't we be, as a rural community, you know, get on the list? But we can also, according to the State Film Commission, we can shop locations to any film producer or TV producer, or even anybody that wants to do commercials, whatever. And Gazelle, I cannot remember her last name, she works with Bob Raines, who's the film commissioner in Nashville. She was telling me that she looked up McNary and Hardin counties, and she said there are a few old pictures of Shiloh, really old, but there aren't a lot of new pictures of just locations. And she said, believe it or not, people sometimes want trailer parks, they want an old dirt road, they want, you know, a small town that's not, you know, very modern, they want, you know, all kinds of sites. So you could look at Coon Creek, Big Hill Pond, you know, the river, whatever. So I hope that we can pull together with Hardin County to make something really great for both of us, if that's what we're proposing.
If the initial amount, let's say it was 40 or 35 or 40,000, what's the time frame of the return?
Of course, early on, he's been working on this since last June. He wanted to start production. His desire was to start production in September, but we're months behind. It would probably be, what, 8 months?
Thank you for that. Because we've really got to think about, and I'm not against anything like that. I'm not trying to speak for the board or anything, but I do think our raises and, you know, we just got to think about things like that first. We don't have the money to put that in, so maybe we'll see what your emails say. So, and maybe go to that meeting if y'all want to. Go to that meeting on Friday. That'll be good.
Did y'all get the information in your emails, or I have
it? I got it.
You didn't get the contract. Does anybody want the contract? I think I sent it to
Do y'all have anything else?
Yeah, I think it's a good idea. I just think that
I
couldn't give the employees a raise, but I could spend the money on that. Mm-hmm. Not saying it's not a good idea. I just don't think it would go over too good. Wouldn't be for me if I was working for them.
Right. All I'm saying is think about it, because if this all goes to Savannah, you're losing millions of dollars on the back end. So and good jobs. That would change lives forever. You know, just think about communities that have had movies and just talk to Angie, don't discount it yet. There's maybe some wiggle
to Angie. We got lots of things.
Angie, you got the money, we'll do it.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. All right. Anything else?
I do.
Okay.
in the past, Tennis Summer has sponsored the Rockabilly event, and this is just a sponsor form, and I would like for y'all to consider sponsoring the event for 2023. The event's been anywhere from $1,000 to $2,000, and I will have the insurance form for you guys tomorrow night, if that's okay.
Yeah, that's okay.
I walked out and never got it.
That's okay. That's good. All right, anything else? All right, then, make a motion. Meeting adjourned. How about that? Thank you.
You ready to get handcuffed?
You want to get handcuffed?
You want to get handcuffed in the back room?